Hello, this is Solomon Lange. How are you today? I'm sure you're having a beautiful day. And your week is going to be an awesome week. It's going to be blessed and full of the grace of God. And this is Swim with Solomon Lange. Today I'm not here with the band, doing worship. I just want to share something that will bless you and really, really, really bless you. Now listen to this. In 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. The New King James Version. It says, command those who are rich in this present age not to be haughty, not to trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who gives us richly all things to enjoy. So command those who are rich in this present age not to be haughty, not to trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who gives us all things to enjoy. New International Version says, command those who are rich in this present age, present world. Say, command those who are rich in this present world not to be arrogant, not to put their hope in wealth, which is so uncertain, but to put their hope in God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. That sounds like Nigerian English, for our enjoyment. Now listen, this verse has this. 1 Timothy 6, verse 17 has two parts for me. The first part is that Paul was saying to Timothy, God was saying to Timothy, or God is saying to you, that command those who are rich with the things of this world. And he was making reference to material things. Those who are rich in money, those who are rich with material things, things that you can see. So command those who are rich in this world not to be arrogant, not to put their trust in the things that they own. Then the second part is saying, it is God that freely gives us, that gives us all things to enjoy. Listen to me. You might be there and you're saying, and you're thinking that, oh, this thing, that this verse is only for people who have a lot of money. But everyone has been blessed by God. Everyone has been blessed with something. Either you have been blessed with money, or you've been blessed with a car, or you've been blessed with a family, or you've been blessed with a gift or a talent, or you've been blessed with a job, or you've been blessed with a wife, with a family, with a relationship. If you listen to my song, Yabo de Kazuchi, Yabo, right? He says, some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord. Now, he's not saying we shouldn't have horses. He's not saying we shouldn't have chariots. He's not saying we shouldn't have kings. Kings or skills. But he's saying, do not put your trust. That's why the first part of this verse, 1 Timothy chapter 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17, he's saying, do not command those who are rich, command everyone who has something, not to put their trust in what they have. Do not be intoxicated by the gifts that you have. Don't put your trust in the money that you have. Don't. And what that really means is that nothing, don't let the things that you have be more important to you than God. When anything becomes more important to you than your relationship with God, you are putting your trust in that thing. If your money, if the money that you have, the houses that you have built, the car that you have, the job that you have, the family that you have, and God has blessed me with an amazing family. But if my family becomes more important to me than my relationship with God, then I am putting my trust in my family. If my gift of singing, my talent of my ability to preach the word of God, to share revelation, if my fame, the fact that people know me, if it becomes more important to me than my relationship with God, then I'm putting my trust in that thing. And the Bible says, woe to them that put their trust in the armor of flesh. So the armor of flesh will always fail you. You see, these things, they pass away. Everything that you see that is physical, there are things that it can pass away. But you see, in God, you have everything. Your relationship with the Lord. Your relationship with the Lord, you should put your trust in God. Do not put your trust in the connections that you have. It's good to have connections. It's good to keep good relationships. It's good to have great friends. friends. It's good to have people in high places and low places. But do not let those people, those relationships, the gifts that you have, your investment, your savings, your work, your skill, it shouldn't take the place of God in your life. Do not put your trust in those things. At every point in time, you must reevaluate your life, reevaluate your heart, and ask yourself, where is my heart? Am I trusting in God, or am I trusting in the things that I own? Or am I trusting in the things that God has blessed me with? Am I trusting in my heart with God, or is my heart, that's my daughter crying over there because my wife is recording for the video. So you must always evaluate your life today, evaluate your life this season. Ask yourself, why did I go to church on Sunday? Why did I go to church today? Is it only that I go because of the relationship that I have with God, or I went to church because I want my problem to be solved, or because of what I want from God? If all my needs are met today, would I still need God? You should ask yourself. Let's have a relationship with God. Tomorrow I'm going to be sharing the second part of this verse with you, right? So the first verse, part of the verse is saying, command those who are blessed with riches, with material things. Command those who are rich in this world not to be arrogant, not to compare us with themselves with other people and feel like they are better than others because of what they have or what they own. When you begin to compare yourself with other people and you feel like you're more important than others because of what you are, when you feel like you are more important than other people, you look down on other people because of what you own, you begin to put your trust in what you own. When you realize that God created all of us, then you're going to realize that what you own, what you have, what you can do, or the people that you know don't make you more important than the other person down the street. Well, that's what I want to share with you today. Tomorrow I'm going to be sharing with you on the other part that says it is God that gives us all things richly. It is God that gives us all things richly to enjoy. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. We'll share the second part with you tomorrow. God bless you. This is Swim with Solomon Langay.